me this time, didn't you? You little paddy bastard. You thieving McCann.
You got it all wrong, Wes. All wrong. It was French, I promise. He said he was going to rip you off. Now he's ripping me off.
Angleby, what?
Mr. Nigel.
Let's get this over with. The saloon's calling me. Come on, then. Let's fight this guy.
Bit of killing, at least.
What's your name, friend?
John. John Marston.
So come back and came along, fella. That's what I dropped you last Christmas there for a second.
Who were those fine specimens of humanity?
They was the only friends in the world. And boy, am I glad to see them bastards dead. We all met on the boat over a few years back, we did. Thickest deals ever since, and that's right there was the problem.
Is it normal for friends in Europe to drown each other?
Never trust a Welshman before, he told me. And he got his throat slit, so he should know. The kind of fellas who would steal an acorn from a blind sow and then kick her for squealing. And as for that French bastard,
he didn't sound very French.
Not for now. The demon bastards are holed up at the cabin by the lake. Can't wait to see the look on their faces when we bash in there. They'd be more surprised than a mud dog with their first porcupine.
You best not be lying to me.
Listen, fella, I didn't ask for your help back there. I don't owe you nothing.
I'll decide what you do and don't owe me.
I've had enough of your overly aggressive manner, fella. You don't know who you're dealing with here.
Irish, I've met enough men like you to last me a lifetime.
You can make quick work of those fellas if they give you trouble. Go and store just inside that shack.
What about you helping me out?
I'll cover you from the ridge. I'm better from long range. It'll be a piece of cake, fella. Trust me.
Ah, Marco can stand to help. Oh, I never realized. Wonder if you can. Nothing here, though.
Sorry, partner.
Holy smacks! Jeez, they're not that far away, are they? Nice.